Hello, welcome to the fourth part of this video series, and this will be a quick video tutorial about the boolean, the live boolean option which is available in ZBrush. And in this I will just give you a very small introduction that how boolean works. So here we go. As you can see that we have this model from our earlier video, and we are going to see that the design part, the spherical design part, and the above golden part as represented in the concept image, those parts are intersecting at the edges. So we can just remove those extra intersecting parts which are inside each other's geometry. So we are going to use boolean for this thing. So as you can see, these parts are intersecting with each other, and we are going to take duplicates of these two parts just for our safekeeping, and we are moving it below and hiding all other parts. Then we will apply the boolean operation, and these options which are here, these are the boolean operation. Like when I have clicked, this is the union option, but nothing is working right now. So for that we have to click on live boolean option, so we can see the boolean in the live preview. But this is not the mesh yet. For creating a mesh out of it, we have to go to the other option. But you can see, by changing these options, you can preview the boolean operations which is going on. So for creating a mesh out of it, we are going to go for the boolean option and make boolean mesh, and it will go through the calculation and it will create a mesh. Like you can see, union remeshing in process. It will go through the process and we will get a mesh in the separate mesh. As you can see, the mesh is U mesh design part 2, and we can append that mesh. We can turn off live boolean again and we can just append that part, because we can find it here and we can append it. This is the mesh, the same mesh which is there above, and we can delete the duplicated part, which was like we just duplicated it for safekeeping. And now you can see the above part is the incorrect part, so we are moving it below. We will delete it later, but the corrected part is this one. We will unhide it, or we can just go to the transparent mode, and we can see that this part is not intersecting now. So we have corrected this thing by just going to simple boolean option and creating a different boolean mesh and just appending that mesh into our original subtools. So we will delete it, the incorrect part which was earlier intersecting. As you can see, we will delete it, and we are here with our corrected mesh. So next video will be interesting, and it will be a new thing, I think, retopology. So let's move on to the next video. Thank you so much for watching.